I stand in the place where my greatest desire is to be with God and to represent His heart and to represent it correctly. That's what true prophecy is. That's what the office of the prophet does, is it takes the heart of God and communicates it to the people. God's heart, His mind, His will, and His intent. When 9/11 took place, we need to go back that far, God began to speak on the very night our church met, and He simply said, "Where the place that the towers were attacked and fell, the nation wounded, I will raise up a president from that place, New York, born in New York, who will bring this nation back on course. And this president will be given 2 terms. That was on 9/11. God began to continue to add to the story. And I met with, as I said before, with Kim Clement, which I didn't know at the time. He didn't know me. We had prophecies that we never released publicly. I didn't release them. He didn't release them. We compared notes. We ministered to some government officials at that time. Both of our mouths were on the floor because God spoke and kept speaking that this would be the sign of America's awakening and reformation when this president from New York would arise. And so then God began to get more specific, and these are documented prophecies where He said, in the 240th year of America's reign is when I will raise up one who shall be like a Moses, and they shall bring a deliverance to this nation from New York. Well, it happened. 240th year of America's reign was the 2016 election. God has not changed His mind. President Trump won. The nation is now in a place where we are being tested. Mark chapter 6 is where we are prophetically. Jesus told the disciples to get in a boat. They get in a boat. They begin to row. And Jesus is coming by way of a visitation. The disciples, which represents the church, misread the signs of Jesus' visitation and think that it's something evil. That's where a lot of people are at today. They cannot see what God is doing. They can't recognize a visitation. But yet Jesus was testing the church or the disciples. And the Bible says in Mark 6 that He intended to pass them by. It was a test. What would they do? Well, they were rowing against a wind that was blowing contrary. We're hearing contrary reports, contrary things that is dividing the nation, attacking the prophets, saying that, you know, God is basically done with America. The prophets are wrong. So these winds are blowing. The disciples are rowing. A lot of chaos is happening in the boat. The disciples finally call Jesus in the boat, and something happens. A great acceleration begins to take place. Mark 6 says, immediately they were on the other side. This is what is beginning to happen. We are now in the season that God is going to fulfill what He has spoken through the prophets. There were the 50 sons of the prophets that did not operate in the high level anointing that came upon Elisha because they were told that the leader would be taken away from them, but they didn't press in. There are some prophets that have backed off. They're not pressing in. And the prophets that will, the believers that continue to press in, are the ones that are going to be rewarded in this day. And there came a time in 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 15, where they said, the 50 sons, wow, the spirit of Elijah rests upon Elisha. They're going to see. These that are criticizing the prophets are going to see that they were in fact right. And I hear the Spirit of the Lord say, I am the God that takes away the old to establish the new. And this is what I am in the process of doing. Do not think for a moment, says the living God, that I am not working or that I have been silent. I have allowed hell to make it appear as though they have won and they are winning, and they have been wringing their hands. They have been celebrating. But God says, great fear is even in the very bowels of hell and those who are cooperating with evil. Why are they afraid? It is because of what I am in the process of doing and what I will do, that I will bring an Independence Day to this nation. I will deliver it. I will set it free. And God says what I do shall take you through the summer months and even into the fall and throughout this year, that what I have promised and what I have declared, 2021, WON, shall be the fulfillment of your battles. And there shall be spoils of this battle that shall be be given unto this nation. And God says, I am not done with President Trump. This is even part of the great awakening that shall cause men's mouths to fall open. And those who have reported even upon the news and have attacked and been part of the lies, they too shall see and be awakened that I am the God that shall step in, and I am the Lord that shall bring great things. Yes, great cancellations, great removals, and great good things shall begin to swiftly come. For men have looked at the 104 days and they say, surely there is no hope for the future of this nation. God says, I laugh at that. Do you understand that even as the Son of God went in the temple and overthrew the tables, I will do the same with the silly legislation. I will do the same with the agenda that they have tried to bring in this time, and I will throw it out because I have promised to give this nation to the children and to my son and to the honor of this nation that has pledged their allegiance for generations. I pledge my honor in return, says the living God. So get ready. There shall be a derailment, and this shall be a sign. Even the insects shall come and be a distraction, but do not be moved by these things, for I will move my hands swiftly and quickly, and I will bring a great return, and a celebration shall come upon this nation and upon the nations of the earth, and men shall even say, we did not think it would happen, but it has happened before us. And those that have been in strife, when they see the truth, when they see the evidence, and when they see the good, they will put their swords down, and a unity shall come among my people in the church, but it shall come even upon this nation, that great healing shall be brought forth. So the Lord says, the days are not prolonged. They are in process. Get ready, for you will see my hand, and you will say, look at what the Lord has done. Remember, things are not over, and things are not going to stay as they are. There is a future, and the future has God in it, and the future has God's intervention, and there's going to be an amazing day coming that we are going to celebrate. I want you to look up Ezekiel 12, verses 21 through 28, where it talks about there was a proverb in the land where they were saying that the visions are failing, they're being prolonged, and God sent his prophet and said, no, that's not the word of the Lord. The visions aren't failing, and they're not being prolonged. They are going to come to pass. Lastly, I want to say this. The lion is roaring, but a few weeks ago, about 3 weeks ago, I saw a vision where the Lord was not just roaring as the Lion of Judah. He was ready to pounce. Get ready. The best is about to unfold.